I'm going to be starting a new series called Preserving Your Harvest. I have so much going on out here that I definitely don't want it to go to waste. I can't possibly use it all fresh, and I don't want it to just die in the ground, or I don't want it all to go to seed or to compost all of it. So in this series, I'm going to be covering how to preserve your harvest for later use this winter for baking and cooking. So the first thing we're going to do today is harvest some basil, and I'm going to show you a quick, simple, and easy way to preserve it that you're going to love. So let's go take a look at our basil here. Well, I've got my nice basket of basil from the garden, and I'm going to show you today how to dry your basil using the microwave. Super easy, super quick, anybody can do it. But first of all, we have to wash our basil. Okay, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to fill the sink up with water, or a couple inches of water anyway. And I'm actually going to put a little bit of vinegar in. Okay, now vinegar is going to kill any of the bugs that are on there. It'll also get it nice and clean. We're going to go ahead and throw it in here, throw that in here, and we're going to let it sit for about 10 minutes, and then I'll come back and show you what to do next. All right, my basil's been sitting in this water for about 10 minutes. I'm just going to rinse it off and lay it here on this cloth. And the reason why we're drying basil is so that we can use it again later in the wintertime for cooking. All right, we're going to dry it and actually stick it in the freezer to keep the flavor nice and fresh. And that way you can have it to throw into your spaghetti sauces, your soups, put it on pasta, all the wonderful, yummy things that you can use basil with throughout the year, not just in the summertime when you have the fresh basil. So we're gonna lay it out here on this cloth, and we're gonna pat it dry just to take some of the extra water off. But we're actually gonna let it sit here for a couple hours, because before it goes into the microwave, it has to be completely dry with no moisture whatsoever on it. So I'm just gonna pat it dry here and just let it sit here for a couple hours till it completely dries out. And then we'll show you what to do next. All right, well, I picked my basil off the stems and it's been drying here for a couple of hours. There's no water at all in the leaves, so it's ready to go into the microwave. So we're just gonna lay it here on this plate. And you want to put it, not real thick. It doesn't have to be completely in a single layer. You can just put it on here, but you don't want to like pile it up high or anything. So just throw it on a plate. You want to make sure it is a microwave safe plate, not a paper plate. I've tried that before and my plate actually caught on fire. So definitely don't want to do that. Okay, ready to go in the microwave, and the microwave's going to make it nice and dry. So let's go stick it in here. You want to put it in the microwave for about a minute and a half, and then we'll check it to make sure it's dry enough and you want it to be nice and crispy. So a minute and 30 seconds, we'll come back and check it out. All right, looks like our basil is all done. I actually had to do it about a minute longer, so about 2 minutes and 30 seconds for this amount of basil. You'll just have to adjust it according to the amount that you're doing. You can tell when it's done, it's nice and crispy, it crumbles easily. Perfect. And I'm just going to crumble it right into my jar here. And this is just one of the ways that you can use basil. There's all kinds of other ways that you can do, but when I don't have much time, this is usually what I do with it. So just crumble it into this jar here, or you can just put it in with whole leaves too if you want. But I'll crumble into this jar, and then I'm going to stick this jar right into the freezer. And I'll just keep adding to it as the season goes on. So let me know what you like to do with your fresh basil. And by the way, this works for any herb as well. If you grow oregano or dill or parsley in your garden, you can do the exact same thing. So I'm gonna go ahead and stick this in the freezer now. Let me know what you do with your fresh basil and if you've had luck with preserving it in any other way. Thanks for watching.